Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, I will talk about dates and handling dates and times in your Codeless logic. Dates is kind of a special thing. It's not a separate data type. A date in Codeless really is an object. And I know we haven't discussed objects yet. However, I thought it would be timely to introduce you to dates and discuss how to work with them, just because there will be a few other lectures before we get to objects where I would like to use dates. Let me demonstrate just a basic example with dates, and then we'll discuss what a date consists of in Codeless. For the demonstration purposes, I'm going to bring our favorite print block back in here, and then notice that there is a date category under system that contains a bunch of blocks. Every single block here does something with date. Some kind of transformation, calculations, and so on. But to start, let's take this date now, which is a block that returns the current timestamp at the time when that block is used. So in here, if I connect it to print, what's going to happen is date now will return the timestamp at the time when it is executed as a date object, and then print will print out that date object. And we will see what's inside of it. Let's run this guy. And you will see that all of this, the whole line, was printed by this print block. And as you can see, there is a bunch of information here. It does say that it is Saturday, December 11th, the year, and the time. And it gives me the time zone offset, which is Central Standard Time, which is where I am right now. So all of this information, even though it is printed as a string, is contained within the date object as individual elements. So whenever you use date now, you get this date object that contains all the individual elements. It knows exactly the day of the week, it knows the month, it knows the date, it knows the year, hours, minutes, seconds, and the time zone. All of it combined is within that date object. Which, by the way, speaking about date object now would be kind of a cool and useful precursor into the whole conversation about objects. But right now we're talking about strictly dates. So with dates, there's quite a few different things that you can do. One of them, for instance, is modifying the date and calculating some other date based on the existing date. What do I mean by that? Let's say we do have a variable that will contain some kind of alarm. So we basically just want to configure an alarm. There won't be any alarms triggering in this example, but since we're focusing just on modifications to the date object. So how would we go about taking the current date and then setting it for some time in the future? First of all, let's declare a variable, and alarm date time is going to be the variable name. And let's set this alarm date time to now. Okay, so now this variable, let's get rid of this because we don't need it just yet. So at this point, this variable contains this date that includes the point of time when it's executed now. And let's say that we want to set this alarm date time to some time in the future. In order to modify your date object, there is a block in here that provides a way to modify any given element of the date object. And this is the block that will provide that capability to do the modification. And as you can see right here in this dropdown, these are individual elements of the date object that can be modified. And we will start simple. In fact, all of this will be simple just to demonstrate how this functionality works, and you can start making it more complex in your applications. So let's say that we want to modify our alarm where it's going to be 1 year from the time when this page runs. So full year is going to be the actual property of the date object that we're modifying. And then the full year will be modified for our variable. So you see, it says for date, and we provide an actual variable. So whatever date is sitting inside of that variable, inside of that box, inside of that date, we're going to take the year and we will assign some other year. And then the year that we will have to put in there is going to be, if I go into math and take this number, right now the year is 2021. You might be, when you watch this video, it may already be 2022, but as of the time of the recording, it is December 11th, 2021. And then what I'm doing is I will modify the year in my variable to be 2022. So we got this date, it points to a point, it contains this point of time, date, hour, minutes, just basically specific point of time on the calendar and on the clock when it is, and I'm basically moving it forward by 1 year by basically setting that the year is going to be 2022. And to see what's going to happen with that date, we will print out the modified alarm date time, because the modification happens inside of this block. So if I grab this variable and then actually let's do it right here. So we will print out alarm date time right after we got the date, and then we will print it out again right after it is modified. So there will be two dates printed in console. Let's run it again. And as you can see here, this is before the modification and this is after. The time is going to be exactly the same because we haven't done anything with the time. But the year, notice that before it is 2021 and after it is 2022. So this did exactly what we wanted to do. Likewise, if we want to change, let's say month, here we can select month, and then let's set the month to 4, which will be April. And then let's rerun this logic and print this date again and see what's going to happen. All right, so now notice that actually number 4, it's May, because it is, the months are zero based, and something that I should have told you right from the beginning. But anyway, months are zero based. January is month 0, February 1, May is going to be month number 4. So by modifying the month to number 4, notice that all the calculations actually took place, and the system knows that it is going to be May 11th and it is Wednesday. So day of the week was automatically calculated for you, because that the system knows what day of the week May 11th in 2022 is going to be. Using this mechanism, you can modify every single part of that date. And there are different parts. You might be asking questions, what are these UTC, date, full year, hours, milliseconds, all these UTC properties are? Well, they technically are the same elements of the date, but whenever you modify them, you're basically saying modify it as if this date points to a point of time in the UTC time zone, basically disregarding the time zone itself. So if you want to set the UTC hours to, let's say, 11 a.m., all right, 11 o'clock in the morning, if it is the UTC, it's going to be the 11 a.m. where the time zone is going to be 0, all right, which means that 11 a.m. in UTC is going to be a different time in a different time zone. So in computer science, and whenever you work with dates in your computer programs, sometimes you just want to take kind of a neutral look without specific time zones. And then in this case, working with UTC is going to be important. And this way, all of these guys, they disregard the time zone. They actually work in the time zone 0. And then all others, they're going to be working with the time zone of where the computer program is running. And in this case, the computer's program is running on my computer, and I'm in the central time zone, central standard time. All right, so this is the block to modify any given element of your date. And then how about the block that extracts and just gives that specific value if you want to know if you have the date and just want to know what month it represents, or what hours, or minutes, or year? Well, for this, there is another block, which is this get time for date. Let's drag it out, and you will notice that in here it's going to be pretty much the same list as on setting, plus a few other things. So let's work with that and try to extract various properties of that date. So first of all, let's start with the first one, day of the month. Let's run it. It is 11. All right, so here, this is the date that we're working with, the last version. And 11th represents 11th day of month May. Let's get some other one. And we can get, let's say, last day of the month. Sometimes it is useful. And in this case, it is going to be 31, because this date represents the month of May, and the last day of the month is going to be 31st. All right, let's see what else we can get here. By the way, you can see that the month, you can get either zero-based, just like when we were setting it, or regular month, which will be based on number one. For instance, if we want to get day of the week, let's run it. It's number three, because it is Wednesday. So Monday is one, Tuesday is two, Wednesday is number three. So day of the week is going to be represented as the number. Likewise, getting any other property will work exactly the same way. So now you know how to modify individual elements of date, how to extract individual elements of date. What other things can you do with dates? Conversion. Date conversion is something that is quite interesting, because there are different date formats and you want to print it out differently, and you just may need to format your date to correspond to a specific format in your application. Let's see what capabilities exist when it comes to date formatting. So let's put this in here. Let's take our variable. And in here, you see these are the different formats that you can convert this date to. For instance, if we use date string and run this page, this is the date string format. If you want to change it to from date string to locale date string, let's run it. I suspect it's going to be about the same. Oh, actually, it is different. So this is the locale date string. And each in every format that we have here will be slightly different. And you may just need to play with it to find the one that works for you. So here it is. This is the locale time string. And let's see what that looks like. There you go. And by the way, the locale time string, like for instance, first of all, locale date string, since I'm in the United States, here we have month, day, and then year. If you would be outside of the United States, where typically day comes first and then month, then exactly the same code right here on converting it to locale date string would look differently. So let's say in Europe, if you were to run this code, you would get 11/5/2022. And same thing with the month. I mean, same thing with the time. Locale time string here does 1:48 to 20 p.m. And in Europe, you would be getting 13:48:20, which is how the time typically is formatted in Europe or other parts of the world. So this is the date formatting. And by the way, timestamp, let's take a look at what timestamp would give us. All right, so this timestamp is an interesting thing. We got this long number. So this long number actually represents the number of milliseconds that passed since January 1st, 1970, to that point of time as to what this date represents. In fact, if you take this timestamp, it is a timestamp, which is number of milliseconds, and then you Google milliseconds to date, and then one of the first results is going to be a page that is called currentmillis.com. And in here you can paste this number, and it does this conversion of taking this milliseconds to the actual date. And you will see that we got exactly the same date that we have in our application. So this number of milliseconds is quite important, just because internally, even though we know that there is a day of the week, there is month, there is day, there is year, times, I mean, hours and minutes and milliseconds and seconds and all of the stuff, internally, the actual date object is being managed as this number of milliseconds. And by using this number of milliseconds, you can actually do some other calculations. And those calculations can be done using this offset date block. So in here, if we take our variable, and you can do plus or minus certain number of seconds. And that what this does is it takes this point of time, and if you add certain number of seconds, then you will be basically creating a new date object that will be modified. And this is how this could work. I'm going to put this in here. And let's add 60 seconds. In fact, let's copy this print again. So this is before the modification, and this is after the modification. And the difference will be is that the result of this block will be different from the original date by 1 minute because we added 60 seconds. Let's see what that looks like. So in here, notice that we have Wednesday, May 11th, 1351, and the next line is 1352. So what we did is we basically added 60 seconds and we got a different time. That was time. This is very similar as to modifying the number of minutes, number of seconds. Sometimes, really depending on the logic that exists in your application, adjusting it by a certain number of seconds, and based on that, you can figure out how many minutes you need to add, hours, weeks, and so on. This may be the preferred way to handle this. What else do we have? We have a date from timestamp. And what this does is it basically takes that numeric value that represents a date as the number of milliseconds. And what it will do is we'll take this number of milliseconds and create the actual date object. Okay, so let's see how that works. And in here, we will take a numerical value. And if we go back to that page where I had that number of milliseconds, by the way, this is the current number of milliseconds right now when I did the copy and paste. And if I put it in here, let's see what we're going to get back. All right, so what we got back is exactly precisely the point of time when I copy pasted this value. And what it did, it translated the number of milliseconds into the actual date object that contains all these individual elements. That's pretty cool. Sometimes it is important because you may be getting a timestamp from some other external system, and you may need to convert it to actual date and then start doing the other conversions. And that's exactly what happened here. Let's see, there is one other block that I wanted to show you, date from string. So what this does is it takes a string value and it creates a date object. So similar to this, where this takes a numeric value, which represents number of milliseconds and creates the date object, this one takes the string value and creates a date object. And let's add another print block and connect this. Oh, I'm doing it wrong. It needs to connect to this. And let's add a string value, which will be text. And how about we do 12/31/2021, which is December 31st of this year. Let's run it. And notice that we got this date object. So now we know it is Friday, December 31st. And since I did not specify the time because the string contains just the date, it initialized hours, minutes, and seconds to zeros. And that's the example of converting string value to the actual date object. There is a lot in here, and I hope I made it clear as to how individual objects that individual blocks that work with the date object work. If you have any questions, please leave a comment, ask your questions. I'll be more than happy to provide additional clarifications. I do hope you found this video useful. Thank you for watching, and as always, happy Codeless coding.